that. Only a single electronics book. Thought I had... Oh, ham radio was only level 1. Ah, I don't have a 3 to 4. I'm missing the 3 to 4 electronics level. So we've already got electronics 3. Is there anything I can craft? Bootstrap me? Fire starter is 1. Anything with real simple requirements. Oh, that's right, I can do the battery. Or the lamp, I mean. Oh, I need one more plutonium cell. Should have taken that power storage unit from the autodock room. That would give me the second plutonium cell I need to get the atomic lamp crafted. Assuming I didn't fail, I'm even up. I could probably do it, but... We'll see. Trying to decide, do I want to spend time here while I've got the opportunity to do some crafting and reading, or do we just go ahead and get moving up to the lab? Did I put anything down here? I did not. The thing I have up here is pretty minor stuff. How much crap do I have sitting here? 300? That includes those metal tanks, though. Almost 200 of the 300 right there. Wait, why, how's it showing me the metal tanks? Oh, yeah, they are there. Alright. So yeah, huge amount of that 300 is 60 liter tanks. So I don't have that much stuff. So we've got lots of storage space. What do I got back here? 162, 87. So plenty of storage for the trip. Oh yeah, I never did find out where the center is. I didn't watch the message. Apparently it's nowhere close enough. It didn't highlight a route out of my starting area here. So it must be nowhere close enough. Oh no, it said located. Location 59 to the west. Ah. Bottom of the red arrow. Yeah, right there. It did show a path. I just didn't even notice. Right down through the middle of the town I'm in. We also have a connecting field to this set of roadway, which will get me to that endpoint, and that endpoint, assuming there's a... not a super forest right in this center section here. Time 5 a.m. Sun's about to come up. Got to make a decision on this NPC and the Jabberwock. I think I'm going to pass time. Let's have a fine needle tea. pass some time. Alright, so it's bright light outside. Tired. Door to the tank is open. Alright, we're gonna try it. I can't think of any other way to really deal with this, so. Doc, what's the matter? I'll do it. I'll be back soon. Where did it put you? I'm not seeing the indicator anywhere, so it may be right on top of us. I'm gonna bet you the NPC dies. Alright, so yeah, he's right there. That's bad positioning. He's gonna kill the NPC. There's no way I'm gonna be able to get his attention and get in my tank, I don't think, without him going to kill the NPC. Man, I really don't want to die to a Jabberwock at this point, but I think it's gonna happen. Either me or the NPC are gonna get flattened. Jabberwock. 17 away. Should be coming right at me. I need to keep him on me, but far enough away that I have time to clamber into the tank and get it closed. The trouble here is Mr. Jabberwock could be chasing wildlife. 19 away. Alright, he's coming towards me. Come on. Problem is, I gotta be closer to him than the NPC until he gets out of the line of sight. I think. Nope, I think he's gonna go. Yep. Oh, there he goes. Shit! Run! Get in the tank! Come on, Jabberwock, get out here. Don't go kill the NPC. He's gonna kill the NPC. I can just about guarantee it. Didn't quite give him enough time to get out and onto me here. Yep, he just killed the NPC. God damn it. Every time. Well, pretty much what I thought was gonna happen happened. I didn't quite pull it off. I thought he was gonna follow me around here. But I got a little bit too far away, and he retargeted on the NPC. Apparently, he got an eyeball on him, so... Oh, well. Come on, Jabberwock. Get out of my little base area here. He's gonna come through the window there, too. Wrong timing. And then the Jabberwock's dead. That easy. Just couldn't quite arrange it with the way things worked out there. Too bad the NPC had no gear, so I got really nothing out of that whole process other than wasting a little bit of gas. Jabberwock is covered up by the smoke. Hey there, Yitter765, thanks for the gib. That's the Jabberwock salute. Let's go look at the dead NPC. Hey there, dead NPC with a subject suit. So close! Thought I had him. Good plan, couldn't quite pull it off. I chickened out a little bit too much when he started sprinting towards me. I should have, probably... I'm not sure how I could have done it differently. Short of maybe moving the tank a little further north before I took the quest, and then making sure I kept pulling him away until I had a chance to get into the tank. Live and learn. No NPC for us. Alright, so 7 a.m. We're tired. Gotta make a final decision here. Go to the lab. Keep searching through the town. I haven't yet made it down to that garage. I think I might stay one more day. We'll sleep. We'll do one more night raid. This time I'll work my way down. We'll hit this group of houses. Try to get to these houses and that garage. Not the police station. I don't want to pass up an opportunity for the garage. I think that's what I'll do. Alright, so towards that end, let's just go take a nap. Put the blindfold on. Do I want to bandage anything? Let's first thing, let's take off two backpacks. And let's grab some makeshift bandages. We'll put some makeshift bandages to use. Alright, and now we'll wear the blindfold. See if something comes and nibbles on us while we're sleeping. Another Hulk. So I have imperceptive healer trait, so I only heal 10% of what is normally healed. So that means I'm a lot of times not even going to heal up a single bar, as I didn't there. It takes quite a long time to heal damage. Alright, no blindfold. What else do I want to drop? Don't want to carry the oxygen tank. Everything else is fine. Have some more pine needle tea. And anything that is... Oop, that sandwich. Sandwich has got to go. And the tofu. That's probably enough. 4 p.m. Read or craft? Work on. Let's get our fab pushed up another level. Alright, good timing. Finished up, level 3 fab, right as the sun's going down. I think we are pretty much ready to go. Have another couple of pine needle tea. What else we got that's perishable? Paper pear, yeah, eat the pear. Cook up the hot dogs, eat the apple. And a pine nut. Should be good enough. The duster is taking some hits. More rags again. What am I down to for sheets? Am I down to my last sheet? 2! Hey, Fertile Creek!
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening to you, too. Thanks for the resub. Appreciate that. Alright, let's try this again. Sewing kits. Duster. Nope, don't try to reinforce. Thanks. Ran out of charges. All right, I think we're good to go. It's 9 o'clock, let's get moving. So we went from thirsty to hydrated status just by waiting a little while. So I'm gonna keep mentioning it until people know, but if you're trying to get used to the new stomach content system, there's delays on the messages. You don't get instant feedback anymore because it takes time for your body to absorb and or digest food and water. So just eat like you think a regular human would. Couple things here and there, and a couple doses of water or whatever drink here and there, and you'll keep yourself in fine shape. You just don't get any more of the instantaneous feedback and change of status like used to happen. And again, it's a work in process, so don't sweat it. It'll be adjusted and tailored as time goes by. Okay, flurries are cutting my vision down. Get our stamina back, not run. We're gonna work our way over that direction. Safe mode back on again. Yeah, the food and hunger messages are freaking a lot of people out. They're trying to just eat and eat and eat and eat, or drink and drink and drink and drink, expecting those messages to instantly change. It doesn't work that way anymore. So it's a lot more realistic now. It's just hard to adapt if you're not aware of what's happening from the old method to the new method. So like I said, just every once in a while, take a couple drinks, eat a few things, and you're good. You really shouldn't have to do much more than that. Alright, something's following me on my trail. I'm gonna cut to the west now, I think. Yeah, right now would be a good idea. A lot of noise. We are slaked. Alright, that's the chain link fence we used to our advantage earlier. Chain link fences are awesome. They block critters, and they also provide line of sight blocking. So if a shock zombie was standing right here, he would not be able to hit me with a shock blast, because the chain link fence blocks his ability for that. So it's awesome to set up certain situations. Now you can shoot through the fence yourself. So if you have a reach weapon that you can hit this space, or if you've got a ranged weapon like a bow or whatever, makes for a really nice location you can get to. Alright, so I think I cleared this place earlier, actually. So we need to get out and across the street. Alright, snow flurries, still cutting my vision range down. That is gunfire. Not seeing an NPC notification. I don't see banks nearby. So there must be another roadblock around the corner or something. Dehydrator? Dehydrator. That's pretty valuable. Oh, Tramadol? Tramadol! Firecrackers. Yeah, they might be. I'm trying to use sound and such more often now for distractions. We'll give them a try. Alright, we need to head south. Good lighter. And again, if you weren't aware, bathtubs hide items. Always step into a space where you can see every space of a bathtub. But some bathtubs are really big. If you step into a center space, you'll be able to see all the adjacencies. We'll grab it until I need room, and then we'll ditch it. Uh-oh, a bunch of books. The Gospel of the Flying Spaghetti Monster! Oh, that's right, I don't have religious books turned off. I'm not used to seeing that book. Duelist's Annual is useful. Don't care about the pot. Ah, what kind of basement did we get? Dead sewer rat, dead sewer rat. Something's in here killing rats. Gonna be another Hulk. Brute and a bunch of other little ones. Alright. Something's making lots of noises. We're out of here. Too dangerous to mess with. Ooh, laundry basket. Me wants, but just for a specific reason. Let's wear it. I'm not gonna fight right now anyway. No vehicle. The mask is okay. Done here. I need to go south through the park. Yeah, which is gonna make a lot of noise. What are they beating up on up here? Guess I'm not gonna find out. Cop car? Yep, cop car. Uh-oh. The working cop car. Might be able to get this up to the base. 1 liter gas. We might make it up to the base on a liter. Engine's in good shape. It's got enough power if it starts. Tempted. Could also dump out the ammonia, go siphon some gas, and then try to... I think I'll do this. We'll remember the position. If I get an opportunity, I'm going to try to get some more gas. Like, maybe from here? Nope, not from here. That is a well-shredded vehicle. Another garage. No. Glove liners that fit. Throw those on. How's my shirt doing? Dress shirt is about to fall off. Let's dump it. Let's throw on the fitted long sleeve shirt. Don't care. Grab the sets. Already got a wood saw. Don't need a brick. Nothing else there. Finding under the hood. Let's go out the back window. Another auto dock potential basement. I haven't heard anything from a cyborg in the back, so I don't think this one's gonna have, no auto dock. Not a surprise. Sure, we'll take some tequila. Golf bag? Golf bags. I like golf bags, they're pretty fun. They're a good ratio, 15 storage for 16 encumbrance. That's actually really good. So, also low coverage, relatively low coverage, so they don't get hit a ton. Unlike the duffel bag, 50% coverage, so it gets hit quite often. It's a 1-to-1, so golf bags not quite 1-to-1, 16-to-15, but less coverage chance, so less chance it'll take damage for a decent amount of carry capacity. But at this point, I don't need it, so we're going to mark that one off. Now we've got a house and the garage across the street if we can get to them cleanly. 2 liters of gas. I think it's time. Let's unload the ammonia and siphon. Set up for this house. Got him pretty clean. Let's check the main bays first. A bunch of nothing. Completely full storage battery. That's pretty nice. Welding goggles. Engines and jacks. Welding tanks. Air jack. Pretty heavy. Jeez. Come on. That's funny. Come on, welder. There's like 4 welding tanks in here. 3 welding goggles. No welder. Multiple air jacks. I don't think I've ever seen a list like this before. Weird. Can't lug that thing around, obviously. It's funny. Yeah, I guess we'll dump the makeshift hammer for the regular hammer. Other than that, a little disappointing and repetitive on what we found here. I have to get in here with a vehicle in order to get that storage battery out of here. It's just too heavy to try to transport. Alright. Full note. Full storage battery. Air jacks. Well, gases. Alright, that house is done. So we've got 3.75 liters of gasoline to throw in that cop car for our exit path. Grabber zombie. Whoops. What's wrong with that? Ooh, this is a tight corridor. Ouch! Alright, I'm about to get boomered. Where am I? Police station? No, I'm not going into the police station. Damn, troglodyte. Alright, this is getting a little icky. I'm not liking what's going on here. I got... Something's knocking down walls. Likely a Hulk type of thing. There's troglodyte chasing me, a runner coming after me. I got a narrow alley that I might have just plugged with... shady zombies. If I try to go for it, I might get sandwiched. There was also stuff in the house, and there's no window out this side, which makes me nervous. I'm concerned. This is a mite concern. So far, we've accumulated what? Gas for the cop car, which would be useful. The dehydrator. Welding goggles. Some food items. And that's about it. That's about it. I'm down one bar of stamina so far. This is going to be where the Hulk comes downstairs after me again. Charcoal smoker. Portable charcoal smoker. Nah, I never use the portable version. Southwest. It's not saying southwest and above, so is that a Hulk in a basement near here making all this noise? Man, that's a lot of noise. There's no way out of there if I go in there. Jogger brute! This is not looking good. This is not looking good. Shocker brood and a big old crowd over there. I think I might have to try to force my way out here. I wasn't liking the stuff that was up here, but I got no other way out short of going back out into this nonsense. There's that grabber. Alright, he moved out of the way a little bit, so we should... Stupid skeletal dog. No acids, at least. More vinegar. Smoke zombie. Alright, well... Made me nervous, but we managed to get out of there. Cop car is back along here. We're in okay shape, no damage really. Didn't get what I was hoping out of the garage. Let's see how nasty things look over this way. Hopefully all the noise going on over there has attracted the local zombies. Whoops, don't be running. Don't want to deal with a bloated right now. So many cop cars. This one's looking almost better than the other one, except for the frame's pretty messed up. The headlights are gone. Should make driving it out of here a little rough. It's gotta be a cockroach house. Of course it has to be a cockroach house. Source of meat and chitin. Jeez, here we go again. Somewhere nearby, another big zombie knocking walls down. Laundry basket. Oh, that's right. I'm carrying that laundry basket right now. I should probably just chop that thing up. Yeesh. Quite a lot of items for 0.5 item drop rate. I haven't really been collecting leather either. Another laundry basket. Another shocker brood outside. They're gonna force me to keep moving north. Bad dog. Duster and duffel bag ripped by the stupid dog. Hey there, observer of all. Welcome. Not going anywhere in the ambulance, but I would like to see what it's got, item-wise. What you got, ambulance? Ooh, adrenaline. Adrenaline's worth it. I didn't even get a chance to see what that was. Is that a corrosive zombie? Hit in the head for one. Yeah, corrosive zombie. That's an upgraded spitter. Well, so this run has been a little rough. We haven't seen too many of the evolved stuff so far, but now we've seen multiple shocker brutes and now a corrosive zombie spit at me through the window and managed to hit me right in the eyeballs with his little acid spit. Got me blinded. Good job. Guess we will walk away from him. Either corrosive. What is that item? Electric blanket. Another new item. To 500 charges of batteries, but it didn't come with any. That's unfortunate. Oh, it did. 10 out of 500. That's funny. Again. Oh, finally. Finally, we have a flashlight. Ah, we better just head out the door there, or out the window. I'm going to call that one good. I think I'm going to back off. I'm getting a little nervous. This area is starting to get pretty nasty. I think I'm just going to walk back across the fields here. We're at, I got a lot of volume because of the combination of the duffel bag and the laundry basket. Fighting would be pretty tough. We picked up quite a few fairly useful things. Filter mask, food dehydrator, Welding goggles, bunch of food items. Still not finding much in the way of medical gear, but we've got all the emergency stuff covered. Oh yeah, I wanted to stop at that police car. So we'll go due west, or due east, I mean. See if we can get that police car out of here. I'd like to have a secondary vehicle that I can do a drive around the area, see if we can come across any body sites and such, before we head on up to the lab. Do a little building scouting. We've got the binoculars already, so that helps. Alright, where are you at, cop car? Down south. You've been facing the correct direction. And it has no headlights whatsoever? That's an issue. Yeah, no headlights. See if we can fix that problem. Oh, I haven't leveled up my mechanics at all yet. I don't have mechanics one. So, were I to try to drive this thing out of here, I would have to drive via map memory. Yeah. Night vision. I could do it. It'd be a little iffy. Might be better if I ran over there and looked at that area right there before I gave it a try. Can't believe I don't even have mechanics one yet. I should have taken care of that back at base before I started running around, just in case I did run across a vehicle. Try it or not. Well, let's give it a go. Bill, that should be enough gas to get us there. This is going to be interesting. Driving with about 4 spaces of map memory. Night vision. Ah! Hey there, vehicle! Alright, now we should be in pretty good shape for the rest of the trip. Yeah, now we're home free. Alright, there we go. 2 vehicles. And a dead Jabberwocky. Stupid Jabberwocky. Looking good. Let's go ahead and get a fire started. Alright, dump off. Laundry baskets. Alright, 1 a.m. We're not tired quite yet. So, we've pretty much covered this northern section here. We've looted all the useful stuff that I care about in that whole section. We hit the school successfully. We crept down around this area a bit, but it was getting a little dicey and we had to bail out of there. So we brought some stuff and another vehicle. It's always nice. I would like to wait till daylight and then take the vehicle for a drive just to check what's at these endpoints right up here. I want to know what my options are before I head into that lab. It's nice that we have a connector up to that big northern city area, but yeah, I'd like to take a drive over there, check those out, maybe circle around the city a little bit, we'll see. We'll have to be able to stop and get some more gas. Hopefully we find another vehicle or two we can do that with. I also have to drive north and make sure there's not a roadblock in this center section here blocking me from getting to the laboratory. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take a trip in the cop car. Let's go get some more gas for it real quick. Let's grab the jerry can. We got plenty of space. We've got some time to burn. Let's run back down to the city real quick. Some of those local vehicles and get some more gas. I don't have to worry about it. Safe mode back on. Might grab some of this raw material while I'm down here too. Pretty useful. Alright, ooh, there we go. 10 liters of gas. Cool. That's about all I need right there. But we'll grab whatever else is available. None. A little more. How much weight am I up to? 69? That's not a problem. This way. Jeez. Alright. That's 20 liters. That's plenty. What else we got back there? Bottle jack. I want a bottle jack. I'm overweight by a tiny, tiny amount. Alright, let's get back out of here. Well, that was pretty cool. 20 liters of gas, real quick and easy, plus bottle jack. Now, do I want this raw material? I do. Sure. Haha, 215. Did I pick up a frame or something crazy? Sort by weight. 33 lumps of steel are 72 weight all by itself. Yeah, alright, I may have gone a little overboard. Let's dump the lumps of steel out. That's too much. 143. How safe do I think I am to run back in an overweight condition with what I've got? Coming down here with a vehicle would be the smart thing. Let's give it a try. Hopefully we don't die. Alright, cool. Plenty of metal, some plastic, copper, plenty of chunks of steel, and a bottle jack. Alright, vehicle's all ready for the trip. So I'm still missing a few important things. I haven't found a wrench yet. Sewing kit, please. So we're missing that important tool. Great. Damage repair, damage repair, and I think I ran out. Oh, nope, I destroyed my duster. That's hilarious. I can craft a full strength, full use duster, but then repairing it, I actually flubbed it and managed to destroy it. That's great. That's great. I are amused. Alright, dust mask. Don't want to be wearing a dust mask. Been hurting my stamina recovery. Am I getting my breath back? That's part of been part of the problem. Okay, time for some more pine needle tea. And damn it, it just did it again. Once again, it says I failed, and then it let me drink. So I ended up drinking water, which then gave me food sickness. God damn it, that's annoying. Getting a little tired of that nonsense. Thanks there, Yitter. That's twice tonight that I have failed to make the tea, and it gave me the consume option, and it consumed just the raw water, which then gave me food poisoning. I do not like. I'm out of 2x4s as well. That are really damn annoying. We'll have a salad, we'll have some wheat cereal, and we'll have a pine nut. That should cover my food needs. Grr, stupid food poisoning. Minus 20 speed. It's right when I wanted to be out and about, too. Yeah, that's a dead Jabberwock. Unfortunately, I failed in my attempt. I knew it was going to happen, and it happened exactly the way I thought it would. Jabberwock killed the NPC before I could kill the Jabberwock. So, quest failed. Yeah, that's just really annoying. That whole fail to make the item, but then it still gives you the consume option, and you end up drinking water that you apparently weren't even smart enough to boil. Well, I've got to give myself food poisoning twice because of that interface hiccup. All right, so we head out anyway. Let's wear glasses. I think we do. We'll just try to make this a purely scouting run. Alright, so I got one broken windshield that I could get zapped through. I'm gonna go north first, make sure my path to the laboratory is clear. Alright, lab path is clear. That would be turrets inside the lab firing away. So, that's good. Next up. worm sign. Oh, we got a helicopter. One pilot. A herd of kitty cats. Pilot, and there is some stuff in the rack. Let's lure the pilot down through the wreckage so he actually hurts himself. We'll wait for him down here. Oh, two pilots. Let's dump the duffel bag. Alright, you guys, lightly damaged each, are you? Food poisoning wore off. Have you guys walk through the wreckage over here. Three bars. Two bars and three bars. This is the kind of tactical movement using the environment to your advantage. So they're cutting themselves on the wreckage as they're walking over it. So I'm forcing them to do that to get to me until I can wear them down to about one bar of health. That way it's a little easier for me to kill them. And we do it. Two bars each still. Go over this pile right here and we should be good. Whoops, nope, that guy's at one bar. Who is it? Guy in back. Alright, let's... Five and two. Good enough. And then this guy just tears me up. Whoops! Ah! How the hell am I using my crowbar? Dumbass. That was dumb. My bad. Alright. Bad, bad, bad form. What do you got for me? Seems pretty good list. Inventory, so... L39B, no ammo. Good lighter, cash card, radio. Don't care. Oh, infrared goggles. I do care. All right, we got infrared goggles. That's awesome. MRE, and I don't care about that. We're going to unload the radio. I'm trying to decide if I care about the gun. I don't think I do. Alright, that would have gone a little better if I'd had my kukri out. I didn't. And we got some Adderall. That's what I was looking for. Adderall and an H&K with ammo. And another radio. So, overall, really good pull for what we had to fight. And holster even, huh? Alright, we'll take the holster as well. Let's go look at what's up in the helicopter. Batteries, and that's it. So that's the kind of opportunity looting I was hoping to do. We came out of that really, really well. 300 batteries, an MRE, infrared goggles. That's low light would be better, but infrared is useful enough to be worth grabbing. And the H&K. All in all, pretty good for such a small site. Oh, we're right up against, we got a gas station on that road to the north. Right up against the, debris, or the, craters from the missiles. Nukes. Ah, another aircraft. Pilots and soldiers. Where at? Up in the trees. Ooh, that's one of the big ones. That could have a lot of them. Yeah, unfortunately... I'd be pretty happy to see that, typically. Oh, was there an NPC to the south? I didn't notice. Oh, there is. Way the hell down there. Oh, that's an awful long way. Must be my extended map vision range that's letting me see that person. Awful lot of horde indicators heading that way, too.